Doesn't it bother you to sleep around without being in love? I mean, don't you have any respect?
I don't screw to get respect. That's the difference between you and me.
Not the only difference, I hope.
Just face it, you're a tease.
I'm not a tease.
You said it yourself, you use sex as a weapon to get respect.
I never said that. She twisted my words around.
So what do you use it for then?
I don't use it, period.
So you medically fridge it, or is it psychological?
You know what I meant. You're twisting my words around.
If you just answer the question.
Why don't you just answer the question?
Yeah, be honest.
No big deal.
Yeah, just answer it.
Come on, just answer the question, Claire.
It's just one question.
No! I never did it!
I never did it either. I'm not a nymphomaniac. I'm a compulsive liar.
You're such a bitch. You did all of this just to fuck me over.
I would do it though. If it's someone you love, it's okay.
You're so weird. You don't open your mouth all day, and then when you do, you unload all of these tremendous lies about me.
You're just pissed off because she got you to admit something you didn't want to admit to.
That doesn't make it any less bizarre.
What's bizarre? I mean, we're all pretty bizarre, right? Some of us are just better at hiding it. That's all.
Well, how are you weird?
Oh, he can't think for himself.
She's right. Do you guys know, what I did to get in here? I taped Larry Lester's buns together.
That was you?
Yeah, you know him?
Yeah, I know him.
You know what hair he is, right? When I pulled the tape off, most of his hair came off. And some skin too.
Oh my God.
And the most bizarre thing is, I did it all for my old man. I tortured this poor kid because I wanted him to think I was cool. He's always going on about, you know, when he was younger, when he was in school, and all the wild things he used to do. And I got this feeling that he was disappointed in me, because I never cut loose on anyone. Right? So I'm in the locker room, and I'm taping my knee up. And Larry, he's undressing a couple lockers down. And he's kind of skinny and weak. I started thinking about my father's attitude towards weakness, you know? And the next thing I knew, I jumped on top of him. Started wailing on him. And my friends, they were just laughing and cheering me on. Afterwards, all I could think about was Larry's father. And what happened to Larry when he went home, you know? The humiliation. The fucking humiliation he must have felt. Must have been unreal. I mean, how do you apologize for something like that? There's just no way. And it's all because of me and my old man. I fucking hate him. He's like this mindless machine that I can't even relate to anymore. He's always going on about, I'm not going to tolerate any losers in this home. Win, win, win. Intensity is for shit. Sometimes I just wish my knee would give. And I wouldn't be able to wrestle anymore. And he would just forget all about me.
Sounds like your old man and my old man should get together and go bowling.
Yeah. It's kind of like me, you know, with my grades. When I actually decide to step outside myself and look, I don't like what I see. I really don't.
Well, what's wrong with you? Why don't you like yourself?
Because I'm stupid. I'm failing short. We had this assignment to do and we had 8 weeks to do it. And we were meant to make this sort of ceramic elephant. And it's supposed to, well, it's a lamp. And when you pull the trunk, the light's meant to go on. My lamp didn't go on. I got an F. Never gotten an F before.